broke the chair? You don't know how the chair was broken? Tell me the name who broke the chair. Silence. What silence? Tell me the name. My dear friends, let's go back to our own school days. We always saved our friend who had broken the chair. So we never told the name of the friend. See the sentence, the chair was broken. Who broke the chair? We don't know. So here you see, even there is no subject, the object, the chair, takes the place of the subject used at the beginning of the sentence. And the agent, there is no place of the agent. And now, when the teacher said that, who will tell the name of the student who broke the chair will be given a prize. Kinjal stood up, said that she had broken the chair. See this sentence. Kinjal broke the chair. In this sentence, the subject is used at the beginning. Kinjal, the doer, the agent. Who is doing? Kinjal is doing the work. And when you see in this sentence, the subject, the doer, the agent is active, doing something actively, the sentence is in active voice, where the subject has no role to play. The subject is act upon. The subject does not act. Such type of sentences, like the chair was broken, is called passive voice. ये फूल का नाम क्या है? ये फूल का नाम क्या है? The answer is there in the question itself. In the sentence where subject is active is called active voice. Where the subject is not active, passive, is called passive voice. First of all, I would like to make it very much clear that what shall we discuss in this class today. In number one, let's know the different real life situations where we use the passive voice. Then the definition of passive voice. Third one is very important, that is, how can you change the voice from active to passive, beginning from school, college examination to that of your civil service examinations. And next we'll know that actually how can you change the active into passive where there are two objects. And finally we'll see some examples, how can you change the active voice into passive voice. Let's start with the first situation that we have already faced, when we are going to hide the doer, hide the subject, hide the performer. You see, the chair was broken. Here we wanted to hide the doer or the agent. Let's move to the second situation, when we don't know the agent or the doer or the performer. My pen was stolen. We don't know who has stolen. And in situation number three, when everyone knows the doer, the thief was arrested, we never use the agent. Everyone knows that the thief was arrested by the police. And in fourth situation, when we focus on action, not the doer. There, you see, my chamber was renovated. We don't mention the names, the name of the engineer, the name of the laborers, or the persons who have worked there. We simply focus on the action, not on the actor. एंड नेक्स्ट व्हेन वी डेवलप ए टॉपिक फॉर एग्जांपल सत्यार्थ प्रकाश इज ए ग्रेट स्क्रिप्चर ऑन द वेदस इट वॉज रिटन बाय दयानंद सरस्वती मार्क द सेकेंड सेंटेंस वी नेवर से दयानंद सरस्वती रोड द बुक और हैज रिटन द बुक यूजली वी से इट वॉज रिटन बाय दयानंद सरस्वती और सिंपली वेन वी वॉन्ट टू डेवलप ए टॉपिक और एन आइडिया एंड फाइनली इन साइंटिफिक और ऑफिशियल राइटिंग वी यूज द पैसिव फॉर्म फॉर एग्जाम्पल द मैटर विल बी डिस्कस्ड इन द मीटिंग टुमारो फ्रेंड्स वॉइस इज द फॉर्म ऑफ ए वर्ब व्हेन द फॉर्म ऑफ द वर्ब टर्न्स इनटू बी वर्ब प्लस थर्ड फॉर्म ऑफ द वर्ब द पास्ट पार्टिसिपल बी रिटेन वॉज रिटेन इज रिटेन देन दिस इज कॉल्ड पैसिव वॉइस Secondly, remember the verb which has an object, that verb can be turned into passive form. I go to school, the school is gone. It's impossible because go is an intransitive verb. It's not a transitive verb. It has no object, neither direct nor indirect object. We'll discuss how there are two types of object in the next chapter. Then you see the position here. Kinjal broke the chair. The chair was broken by Kinjal. Broke is a transitive verb. What? Kinjal broke? The answer comes the chair. It's the object. And you see the position. Kinjal came to the last to the end, that is by Kinjal it became the agent and object the chair went to the position of the subject, the prime position of a sentence in passive voice. And how the verb changed from broke to was broken, part simple, we'll discuss later on. But remember, in only 20% of sentences in English we use the agent, even the agent is kept in round brackets. So voice is the form of a verb that shows whether the subject is doing something or something is done to it, whether the subject acts or it is act upon. And finally, we can say that the active voice sentences, they are subject-centered sentences. And when we talk about the passive sentences are object-centered sentences. Friends, while discussing the definition of voice and passive voice, I told you that how the structure of passive voice, the construction of passive voice, the make-in of passive voice is B verb plus past participle, B plus V3. You may take a screenshot of the page of B verb and later on you will see how all the passive form, all the passive voice sentences, they are made by this B plus V3. For example, you see that am, is, are, was, were plus third form of the verb. It is simple. When that is being plus third form of the verb, that is progressive form. Perfect form, been plus third form of the verb. And when there are the use of modal verbs or modals, there will be be plus third form of the verb. And remember, next we are going to prove in the Subhanastra, in the golden formula. Before that, let's know one thing. Sometimes instead of be verb, we use the get verb. फॉर एग्जाम्पल द मैन वॉज हॉट एंड वी यूज गॉट हॉट ही गेट्स पनिश्ड ही इज पनिश्ड इंस्टेड ऑफ बी वर्ब समटाइम्स ऑल्सो वी यूज गेट वर्ब बट रिमेंबर व्हाइल यूजिंग दिस गेट वर्ब इन द प्लेस ऑफ बी वर्ब वी नेवर यूज द एजेंट बाई समवन एल्स नाउ लेट्स मूव टू द वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग पार्ट ऑफ अवर डिस्कशन दैट हाउ कैन we change the voice from active to passive. It is the golden formulas, Subarna Sutras, that I have learnt from my father. Let's see. You may take the first sentence. I write the book. The book is written. So you see the sentences, those will be in present simple. It's the golden formula through which we can change the voice from active to passive. If you say, I write two books are written by me. I play cricket, cricket is played by me. Like that, you see how there is present simple, present progressive, present perfect, and then there is the past form, the most easiest form. Again, I wrote the book was written by me. And let's move to the modal verbs. Modal verbs, will, would, shall, should, may, might, can, could. The easiest way, I will write the book will be written by me. Some other forms also we can learn. For example, if it will an order, write the book, let the book be written. Then you can say the request form, please write the book, you are requested to write the book. Then if the suggestion, love the kids should be loved. If it is an advice, or a piece of advice, get up early, you are advised to get up early. Or if it is too infinitive, he asked me to write a letter, I was asked to write a letter. And remember, my dear friends, there is no passive structures of present perfect progressive. That is, I have been writing the past perfect progressive. I had been writing, then future progressive, I shall be writing, and the future perfect progressive, I shall have been writing. Usually, we don't use the passive form of these structures. Friends, there are certain verbs which have two objects. For example, they are give, send, show, lend, pay, promise, refuse, tell, offer, etc. We shall take an example that how a verb has two objects. I gave him a book. Here him is an object and book is another object. Book is called the direct object and him is called the indirect object. In most of the cases you will see that children face problem while getting the object of the sentence. I go to school. There is no object. How do you know? For example, in most of the cases, when you put a question like what, the answer comes as a thing, that is the direct object. And when you put the question whom I gave, usually the answer is him and it is the indirect object. Usually, in most of cases, we see that we can find the direct and indirect objects in this way. So here also you see that how can you change such sentences into passive form? We may take any of the objects. Either we'll take him to the beginning of the sentence, or you may also take a book to the beginning of a sentence to make it into passive form. So him, at the beginning when it will be used, it will be he. So he was given a book. You can change it using the him as the object at the beginning of the sentence. Or if you say a book, you will take to the beginning of the sentence, it will be a book was given to him by me. You may use by me or you may not use. So in this way, we can turn the sentences of the active into passive when there are two different objects, direct object and indirect object. But out of two, usually he was given a book is more common in use in the modern English grammar and modern English language. Friends, finally, we shall discuss about some special cases where we change active into passive form. For example, it is the ing form, present participle. It is the two infinitive, or sometimes the verbs, they are followed by prepositions. Let's see, and please note down. First, you may take the screenshot and note down them later for your reference. You see, I want everybody to understand this. It changes into I want this to be understood by everybody. Then I don't like people staring at me. I don't like being stared at. Honey tastes sweet. Honey is sweet when it is tasted. They threw stones at him. Stones were thrown at him. Don't keep him at the beginning that he was thrown. Okay, it will be stones were thrown at him. Nobody listens to her. She is never listened to. It is time to close the office. It is time for the office to be closed. There is a lot of work to do. There is a lot of work to be done. This was all about a brief discussion on passive voice. Friends, my dear children, if you have any doubt, any problem, any questions, please put them in the comment box. I must answer you. That's all for today's class. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.
Hello everyone. If you like Pranav's classes that you've seen just now, then please do like, comment and share and hit the subscribe button. Thank you.